Hey folks, this is Shock, and we're going to be doing a video on how to ride a motorcycle and different things about the motorcycle, how to get a motorcycle, what motorcycle should you get, how to get your license to get a motorcycle, motorcycle. So this will be a video for those of you that like motorcycles. Now, you're looking at a Suzuki SV1000S, and we're going to be showing you different components of the motorcycle. And of course, all motorcycles are different. Some of the brake levers are in different positions. Some of the shifting is a 5-speed or a 6-speed, etc. So keep that in mind as I go through this. But traditionally, on most bikes or the Japanese bikes, the right side is braking. This is the front brake here. This is the rear brake here. You put your foot like this and you push down on that lever there, and that brakes it. It's very hot, by the way, in California today. Let's mosey on over to this side. Typically on motorcycles, the left side is shifting. This is the clutch. You know how in a car you put your left foot in and then you shift with your right hand, right? Well, here, this is like if you put your left foot in, you pull the clutch in. Then here's the shift lever, and let me do some explaining on this. And by the way, I have a little grip here. You get these little shift socks for it, so it grips better. But you're basically, your foot goes underneath this lever right here when you're going to start shifting up. So let's say I'm at a traffic light, and I'll show you how I do it. And I want to start moving the vehicle. I'll pull the clutch in, which I'll show you, and then all the way down on the lever is first gear. So I'll kick all the way down, I'm in first. So I start going, then as you hear the gears winding out, like you're ready to shift, I pull the clutch in, I keep the clutch in, and I kick up. Now I'm in second, and then I release the clutch, just like a car. And then when I'm wanting to shift up again, I release the throttle, I pull the clutch in, hold the clutch in, and I kick up again. And this is 6 gears. So as I kick up, 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 up like that, it's ratcheting up, up, up. It goes up to 6 gears. When I want to slow down, I go down, down, down. I put my foot on top of the lever and I go down, 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 and I shift that way. And I shift downward. What else could I tell you? What do I got here? Oh, you could get like a bike that's carbureted. Most of the bikes coming out now are fuel injected. But there's tons of motorcycles out there that are carbureted, and sometimes based on your weather, if it's very cold, there'll be a little lever over here, right? And you'll pull the lever almost all the way out or halfway, it like moves back and forth. And then when you start the motorcycle, as it starts to warm up, you start to put the lever back. And that helps you to basically choke the engine, so to speak, and to get it going. This is a fuel-injected motorcycle, so fuel-injected, cold weather, hot weather, it just does it all by itself. You don't have to do anything like that with the choke lever. And like I said, it's very hot out here in California. I got all this gear on. But the love I have for my subscribers, it's all worth it. Another thing I highly recommend is these little foam earplugs. You can get them real cheap at Walmart or some of the sporting goods stores. And they don't block out all the sound, so it's safe, but it blocks out a lot of the sound, and you could actually enjoy your ride better without all the noise. If you're getting lots of wind and everything, this could damage your hearing, so I strongly recommend that. So let's get on the motorcycle, and I'm going to put this camera, check out the camera in the mirror here on the left. I'm going to put this camera in this helmet. And then we're actually going to go on the street and then on the freeway. I don't want you guys to get killed, so I'm going to give you some training here. You have a lot to accomplish on this world, so it's not your time to go yet. So here we go. Turn the motorcycle on, you wait for all the electronics to do their little show there. I'm going to pull the clutch lever in and push the start button until it starts. One of the major mistakes riders make is they forget to pull up the kickstand. Okay. You guys ready? So now we're going to show you braking. And what I like to do on braking is I like to kind of, I use the front brake and the rear brake at the same time, but I do slightly use the front brake first. I like how it will throw the bike forward a bit.
Seems, I don't know, maybe it's my imagination. It seems like it's more effective at stopping. So here we go. Let's wait till I get up to the traffic light and then I will do it. So now we're going to stop. We pick up some speed going up to second. Now when you want to stop, watch, front brake and now rear brake. I'm kind of just squeezing it like an orange sort of. And now you're stopped. I actually let go of both
brakes. I hate to say it, but it's very hot. Can't wait to start going to get some wind in here. And I can just sit here at the light. I have the neutral light on. And now we're going to talk about shifting. Now that you know the braking, okay? We're in neutral.
Pay attention to this. This is the tricky part. We're in neutral. I'm going to pull the clutch in. I'm going to kick. Well, see the light right here on the right, how it's green?
I'll kind of watch that. I know some guys say, oh no, it's safer to hold it in gear. I disagree. If you get rear-ended from behind and you got it in gear, you're going out in the middle of the street.
Or your bike's going out there without you. I have the clutch in, I kick down, neutral light's off, I'm in first. Remember, I'm letting the clutch out slowly, giving it throttle. Look, I'm in first, my hand's not even on the clutch. Clutch in, kick up, I'm in second. Now watch, we're gonna go to third. You can't see my feet down there, but watch. Clutch in, I'm kicking up. I meant to say kick up if I said kick down there. I meant clutch in, kick up, I'm kicking up. All the way up. So I'm in third right now. We'll go up one more gear. Watch, clutch in, kick up, I'm in fourth. Now watch, I'm gonna shift downward. It's like a ladder. Clutch in, kick down, I'm in third. This light catches me about 90% of the time. So watch, no one's behind me. So clutch in, kick down, I'm in second. See how it helps you to stop? Remember on the braking? A lot going on, see? Clutch in, I'm in neutral. See the neutral light? And we stop. Now when you first do it, it does take a lot to, no one's behind me so I can show you this. It does take a lot to get coordinated. Clutch in, kick down, I'm in first, slowly give it throttle while slowly letting off the clutch, exactly like a stick shift car. All right, this is where most of you new motorcycle riders end up in a body bag, the freeways here. So here we go. Higher fatality risk on the freeway, but less chance of getting in an accident. Did you know that? There's less chance of crashing on the freeway, but if you do, the higher fatality rate. So I'm in first. With freeways, clutch in, kick up second. With freeways, speed is life. You don't want to be moping along, so let's pick up. Clutch in, kick up third. I like to be going slightly faster than everyone else. We're in third, see how it gets a little bit more. Clutch in, kick up fourth. Yeah, everything that you're usually doing on the street is accelerated. Your thinking has to be accelerated. We're still in what gear? Fourth, right? Watch. Clutch in, kick up fifth. I have six gears here, so watch. Clutch in, kick up six. Now, I want to show you something as I go by this semi over here. This takes some getting used to. Sometimes on very windy days, the wind will actually just blow you almost in the other lane if the wind's real powerful. But driving next to semis, see this? You know that would hurt if I fell underneath there. Ouch. So now, it's pretty easy, see, you just settle in, and bada bing. and you get great fuel economy. I mean, check it out. The tack isn't even at $5,000. It's like a little bit around $4,500. So let's see what else we could talk to you about. What else do I got here? Let's talk about how to get your motorcycle licensed. Now, a lot of people don't know this, but in most states, they'll give you a partial motorcycle license. I think it's called M1. I think there's M1 and M2. And they'll give you a partial motorcycle license where you actually can go riding that day if you just take the written test, you know, with the pencil. Oh my gosh, it's already 10 minutes. I got so much to tell you guys. Hey, if there's an annotation here where it says, click here to see my motorcycle videos, click that at the end of this video or right below this video so you can see more. But anyways, you go to, what I would suggest doing is this. Contact MSF, that's Mary Sam Frank. MSF course, they're going to charge a small nominal fee. Sign up for that. They'll teach you everything you know to ride a motorcycle. Now, this is my opinion. If you're getting a motorcycle, it's pretty dangerous on these freeways to have a low-powered motorcycle. I suggest not starting on a 250. I would start off, because I've had a 250, I've had a 600, I've had a white ZX10, 1000. Now, of course, for me, I'm a little bit more experienced than a brand new rider when I was new. I like the higher power of the bikes, the better, so this is 1000. Because you never can get enough power. The motorcycle riders out there that have been riding will tell you it's never enough. You always need more. You always want more, especially on high-speed freeways. So I think a good balance is like right around a 600. Be very safe, and if you're going to be going on the freeway, 600. If, why is that flare in the road? Oh, I see, they're stopping it. Left lane's closed. So, let's see. I'm not supposed to cross that double line, but let me get over. Let's see what else I got to tell you. Oh yeah, so you go to MSF course, and they'll teach you how to ride. Or you can go right now today to DMV, as long as you know some of the basic questions on the written test. And they'll give you a license. You can go out practice, but it'll have some restrictions, like you can't ride like I am on the highways. You only can ride on the streets because, of course, the fatality rate's higher here on the freeway. And you cannot ride with passengers, and you can't ride at night. And if you do that, you're sent to bed without any cookies and milk. No, I'm just kidding. But they do treat you like a little kid. Once you take the riding test, the motorcycle driving test, let's call it, so you don't think I'm talking about riding written, I'm talking about when you get on the motorcycle and ride it. Once you take that and the written test, you have both of those tests accomplished, you're now a full-fledged motorcycle rider, my friend, and you can ride. Let's see what else I could talk about. We talked about the earplug, how to get your motorcycle license. There's one other thing. And you might want to look for my videos about counter steering. There's a really neat phenomenon with a motorcycle. Let's say I'm going over 50 miles an hour and the turn is turning gradually to the right.
Okay.
What you do on a motorcycle, you don't just turn to the right or you'll crash and flip over. What you actually do is you kind of pull back on the left handlebar and watch what it does. Watch. See how it leans it to the right like that? And you just give slight pressure. See how it leans it like that? And you'll actually go around the corner just by giving pressure. You apply pressure points to the handlebar. So watch this. I'm going to get in the other lane and I'm going to pull back on the left. Watch. See how I do that? That's kind of an example of counter steering, even though I'm going straight. Now, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to ride with the full armor. You know what I'm talking about. And this is Shock. I love you guys. Ride safe. Don't forget to chat with us live right below here at shotgunnow.net.